Thank you, House Chair. The Office of the Chief Justice and the Judicial Administration was established primarily to support the Chief Justice in executing his or her administrative and judicial duties as head of the judiciary and head of the Constitutional Court. And the ACDP wishes to commend the judiciary and the OCJ for the support that it provides. The judiciary have not wavered in holding the executive and even parliament to account and has been a bulwark against state capture and reckless executive decisions. And we from the ACDP side are fully supportive of courts holding ministers and officials personally liable for legal costs caused by reckless political decisions, such as the SASSA pension and welfare grants scandal. Chairperson, the OCJ has allocated an annual budget of $2.3 billion for this financial year. And the ACDP shares concerns expressed by the committee in its report that it and the judiciary, in fact, is underfunded. And we've heard of dilapidated courts. We've seen a shortage of tools of trade, such as law reports. And this, in our view, is unacceptable. Chairperson, the ACDP also understands that the Secretary General was not able to respond to certain queries during the briefing to the committee relating to court performance, as this lies in the domain of the Chief Justice. Now, members of the previous Justice Committee who attended the Chief Justice's briefing in this regard in November last year also felt at that occasion that there was insufficient time to engage with the Chief Justice on these and other matters of mutual concern. The recommendation was then made that through the Speaker's office that the Portfolio Committee and Parliament should meet with the Chief Justice and the heads of court. And this has been a practice over the years. And this recommendation was accepted by the committee, and we look forward to such meeting taking place before the end of the year. We would like to add that members of the representatives of the magistracy should also attend that meeting. Now, a further matter which should concern all of us in Parliament and serving in this committee in particular is the delay in amending laws which the Constitutional Court has found to be constitutionally wanting and sent back to Parliament. Following such a judgment, the relevant departments propose amendments which Parliament must then pass within a specified time limit. However, there have been inordinate delays from the executive side, which places enormous pressure on Parliament. And in certain cases, certain departments have approached the court for an extension of that time, and that extension has been refused because the department, in the view of the Constitutional Court, has not done enough to propose amending legislation. However, one needs to remember that the court order was given against Parliament to remedy that legislation. And it is Parliament that would then seem to be non-compliant with those court orders. And this is a matter that requires Parliament closely to exercise oversight over the departments, as it would not be good for Parliament to be seen in contempt of court through no fault of its own. Chairperson, lastly, the ACDP would like to thank all those members and officials involved in the judiciary, in both the higher and lower courts, who dispense justice on a daily basis, often under very trying and difficult conditions. It is much appreciated. The ACDP will support this budget vote. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Honourable Member.